Fishing for me has never been about the fish itself. It's about the moment. It's about the memories. And most importantly, it's about the adventure. As a fisherman from the boring state of Illinois and a self-acknowledged fib, I'm headed on a road trip to experience all that Wisconsin has to offer. Welcome to Backwoods Bassin. What is good, boys? It is B-Mail here from BD or Big Drip Bassin, and as you can see, we are in the truck right now. We are towing the boat, and we are doing something special right now, guys. We are doing a little Wisconsin tour. We're gonna be fishing all around southern and northern Wisconsin, catching anything that swims for the most part. But you know what we target, you know what the name is. We're not BD walleye, we're not BD muskin, we're not BD piking, I don't know. We're BD bassin. So we're gonna be targeting a lot of bass on this trip. We're gonna be trying a lot of new bodies of water, seeing if we can conquer them and catch some big old bass. Overall, guys, I am beyond pumped. As you can see, I'm going to be gone for about 3 weeks right now, filming all this juicy content for you guys. So I have literally my PC set up. I don't know if you can see it right now. Sorry, I'm currently, you know, driving. This is probably not something I should be doing right now. However, I have my whole PC set up, guys. I'm gonna be cranking out the editing on these videos on the road, so we gotta grab a little gas, and then we are gonna be at lake number one. Pick you boys up in a little bit. So I drove 40 minutes from the point that I said I was gonna get gas, and I didn't pass a single gas station. Welcome to Wisconsin.
Again.
No.
Swear to God, on my life.
Dude, bro, can you stop lying to me, Eric?
I don't want a bite feels like.
I don't. Do you though?
I just put a new trailer on.
I would say.
What?
I told you.
You got one again? Is it a good one?
Oh. Oh, go. I want to get the net just because we got to secure the bag.
Oh. Still got him?
No.
Felt like a really good fish.
Really?
Yeah.
God. All right, one put on. Should I put on the bladed jiggeroo?
Dude, he felt like a real.
No.
And he stayed down.
Oh, dude.
Oh.
Dude.
We never really did an intro once we got to the lake. Obviously, I've talked to you guys in the car ride. Very irresponsible of me. However, it's okay. We got to set the scene. We are out on a lake fishing a nice weed flat in the middle of the lake. Let's see what we can put together. Eric, stop losing fish and teasing me. We need content, Eric. I need to bring people that catch fish on my boat so we can have content.
But it's almost like I'm so, like, last...
Oh, got him? Good one?
Let's go. I'm getting the net no matter what.
Aw, Pikey. Yeah.
You got him?
Yeah.
All right, Pike, bite. Ooh, ha, ha. Little glizzy gobbler. As Captain Eric Leonard once has said, a face only a mother could love. Oh, there we go. Not what we're after. Get him back in there.
Not even a little.
Yeah, the vegetation did get a lot more dense here too. Okay, it's a little more sparse coming this way, but it gets dense right here. Let's so we should cast this. So I say we cast like...
Yeah, that worked.
Yeah, down this. That's what I'm thinking. Getting bit on that one.
There he is. Good head shakes. Is that a pike? I'm gonna guess. Bite like one. It's a nice fish, whatever it is.
Felt pikey.
You wanna just net it?
You want me to?
Yeah, just net it. That's a pretty good one.
Yeah.
Fatty. Boom.
All right, well, my fish.
I didn't know it when I first saw him. I didn't know if your net was big enough for him, so that's why I was going to just grab him.
He looked bigger than he
did look bigger.
Out.
Water magnifies him 33%, you know.
All right, guys, well, my first fish of the expedition.
Hook already came out of him.
Bill, oh, yeah, I thought he was way bigger than that. Don't need a photo of this guy. This is a little glizzy, but you can go ahead and take a photo and send it to your boy.
Smile. You look like you're about to drop a mixtape.
BD Bassin's hottest tracks. Oh, no, not on my deck. Not on my deck. All right, guys, well, we're not going to complain with that glizzy gobbler, I guess. Gets the first fish for me in the boat. Let's get her back.
Yeah.
If we are throwing a jackhammer in pike territories, this is a spell for disaster. But if you want to catch a big bass, there's no better bait. It's funny I say that as I caught my PB on the Picasso bladed jig. However, the ultimate confidence bait is the freaking jackhammer, boys. Let's go whack them.
And
There he is. God, Pike. I probably bolt flip his ass.
I just grab him right behind the head, though.
BD Piking, guys. We got another glizzy in the boat. This is an absolute dinkatron.
Bye.
Disgusting.
Oh, right at the boat. I saw him God. Eat it.
Oh, dude, the trophy.
Wacky rig. Beep, beep, beep. Let's go. The pike killer.
Damn it.
All right, guys, this is my, yep, bye. I hate him. We've been using so far, both of us are running the Rip and Chatter, right?
Yep.
So we got the Legend Tourney Rip and Chatter. This is my first time getting to use it, and it's quite good. Unfortunately, we haven't caught the right species so far. However, keeping the fish pinned, it's strong enough where I'm ripping through grass, and it's not bending like a super, it's parabolic enough to keep the fish pinned. I'm ripping through grass. It's strong enough where I'm not getting all that parabolic bend through the rod, and I'm getting good hook sets in the fish, keeping them pinned. I'm pumped. Let's go. Give me the nugs.
Go find the right. Go find the right kind.
Yeah.
That was like a little boulder right there.
No, some rock.
Some rock, yeah, that's a kind of, oh my God, pike right there. Jeez, dude, I watched him eat it. It scared the tits off me. Yeah. Son of a nut. Dude, oh my, all right, well, oh, get out of here. Dude, I hit pike. Dude.
This is a swim bait rod, but I figured it's got more of a.
Yeah, for that big blade, I mean, I think a moderate fast for that would be the key.
And it's on straight braid, which I think is good.
That's the way to do it. Oh, look at that. Oh, right in the boat. That was so sick.
What was it?
Dude, that was so sick. It was just, it was like a glizzy pike, like a little one. And he comes up and just yoinks it. Dude, oh my goodness.
I'm not going
to. I might need to put mine down. Oh, he's tailing it. He's tailing it. Holy shit. Did you just see that? He was tailing it. He was right behind. It was like a musky follow, dude.
That was a good pike. I really hope you got that on camera. That was
cool. Oh my goodness.
That was cool, dude. That I'll give you.
That was wild. That was maybe a 30 incher. You think? You think it was that big?
34 probably.
No kidding.
35 maybe. That was a good pike, dude.
The amount of small pike Eric and I caught in the last hour was ridiculous. We're not even targeting these things. Like, we're targeting green carp, bro. I was literally throwing the most random baits to catch these fish, and I decided it's time to pull out the big guns.
You know what I actually wanted to throw? And like, I could throw over the vegetation, but it is risky because of the money. I have glide baits. I have some cheaper ones that I wouldn't really care about losing, though.
Even this Thunderhawk would get smoked.
Oh my God, whatever.
Honestly, I'm gonna go with the S waiver. I'm gonna put on my buzz bait rod though. Oh, well, got him. It's a bass. The largemouth and the glide bait. It's a good one too. The one thing I catch on the freaking glide bait is the largemouth. Yes. All right, guys, well, we got a 7-inch river to see S waiver. We got a largemouth bass, probably what? That's a 3-pounder for sure.
Three
something, just because it's super fat.
All right, well, our first good largemouth of the day, guys. Let's get her back home. Let's go.
Yeah, but we all have both. Yeah, oh, absolutely. I would imagine.
Oh, geez, all right, I'll let you go.
All right, buddy, we'll talk to you.
It's a giant!
Okay. Bye. I didn't want to.
Oh my gosh, let's go.
I didn't want to give him any slack.
That's a pig, dude. Dude, that's a pig. You said freaking dead sea out here, bro. Let's go. Out of nowhere, I watched him eat it too. I was watching your bait.
Show the camera. Show the freaking camera, boys. That is a sweet stud right there.
See from fanning down here on the bottom of the tail?
Yes, dude. That is a beautiful freaking fish. Want to get that thing on a scale?
Yeah.
Let's go. Let's see her.
4.45.
4.4.
Nice, dude.
It's a good fish, dude. For how small that mouth is on it, too. Dude, they're just built good. Give me the nucks. Brother, let's go. Buddy. Well, guys, been going pretty good so far. As you can tell, we've been having a freaking pike smackdown. However, I hope the camera caught the audio on that. What did you say? It was a dead sea? He said it's a dead sea. We've been having, it's been slow, just, you know, some pike follows, a couple pike bites here and there, but a dead sea for the largemouth we're targeting, and out of nowhere, that 4.5 pounder comes up. I watch it just smoke his bait. I'm pumped, but we got a long day ahead of us still. We're gonna try to get, you know, a lot more big largemouth in the boat. There's bigger ones in here, and let's go catch them.
Let's see.
First fish for me.
We bring Mitch on the rig. We haven't done really any talking so far since we have. We kind of were just feasting on some McDangs. How do you feel about that, onion boy?
I feel unhealthy.
You feel unhealthy and not well? What do we got here?
264.
264?
That's okay. It, that really.
Nice. We'll make it look pretty big on the camera rig for Mitch over here. Go work, go work.
Sick.
Awesome.
That was a good fish, though. I would have thought it went three.
Yeah, it looked
like it. Just because it was pretty thick.
I would have thought it went 2.7.
It just didn't have the, it had the length, it didn't have the girth, you know?
Kind of like me.
Yeah.
I'm talking about my fishing rods, dude. I don't know what you guys are talking about. I don't know. I think it's all preference, honestly, and confidence, and there's situations for all that, I would think.
Right in the drop.
What else would it be?
They're all like a 25. Or
they're all like the same size and extra obnoxious.
Hey,
I know.
On this bait.
Come here, mister. All right.
There he is, yeah. You don't need it? That's a stud.
Good fish, bro.
That's a 4-pounder.
All day.
I threw up kind of on the inside of these rocks with my chatterbait. My rod just stopped. This one choked it. Red mount. But probably a 4.5 pounder.
Grab the weight.
4.30.
The name of this first lake seemed to be pike, unfortunately. Eric and I kept track of how many pike we caught in the day, and we literally caught over 70 pike on the day. Obviously, we left a ton of catches out because an hour of pike catches would probably be very boring. I ended up getting very sick the night after this video, but still decided to make one short send out here before I went up north. And I pulled off something pretty funny. All right, boys, well, I'm not feeling well at the moment. We right now have the trolling motor running it by this joint. And we're gonna lay here and see if we can catch anything that swims. Got him. Got him. I'm not moving a muscle here, Andrew. Get the net for me. Wasn't my proudest hook set. Come on this side. Oh, Andrew, give me the
legendary.
Nice. Welcome to BDBassin. This catch is sponsored by St. Croix Rods, Sorority House Illnesses, and BDBassin.
See ya.
We can be heroes.